Hello friends, today in this video we will learn about one of the beneficial feature of Marg software, that is claims and statement. Firstly, let's understand about claims. As you have normally seen that in order to boost or increase the sales, distributor offers some schemes to the retailers. On that behalf, retailer can claim and avail the benefit of the schemes as offered. As the distributor and retailers gets offer from the company. For example, they offered that if you will buy 100 quantity of Lux or Dove, any of this in 3 months, so we will give you 5,000 rupees as a bonus. Or we will give you any gift or gift voucher, etc. So to promote himself, supplier had made some kind of schemes. The scheme offered to the retailers, and the retailers had purchased that scheme accordingly, but after that they forget to claim its benefit. So to avoid this kind of problem, you can use the claims and statements feature of Marg software and avail the benefit of claims. In the same way, Marg software has an option of sales claim too. Similarly, as we have also offered the same kind of schemes to our customers or salesmen form of bonus, incentives on doing the sale as per defined of a particular product. Like suppose we offered to salesmen that if they sell so much quantity of any of the products, then they will get the incentive or bonus. Through this feature of claims and statements, the user can do the entries of their own claims, which are given to the customers, salesmen, and we can also maintain the claim which needs to be taken by the supplier. So firstly, let's see the process of purchase claim. So first of all, you will specify that the offer which you will get from your company or supplier, that offer valid from which date to which date. Then is select supplier. As you will enter on yes, a ledger window will appear in front of you. From here, you will choose which supplier or from which company you have received this offer. For the purpose of selecting, you will press plus key. Now, if you want, then you can also select the multiple supplier as well. Now suppose Britannia company have many C&F. So this offer comes directly from the Britannia company, that if you had purchased products of rupees 5,000 from any of my supplier, then you will get a reward against this. So in this case, you will select all the ledgers of that supplier, and after selecting, you will press the escape key. Next option is no. If those suppliers' ledger that you have selected and you want to unselect them, then you will select no option. Next option is select. Here you have three options: items, company and category. Like suppose Narala Pharma has offered you that if you have purchased any one, either moisture soap or Lux creamy white soap of rupees 15,000 between the dates 1 to 15, then they will gift you a laptop. So for that, you will select the items. Then you will select yes. If you have to select a single item, and if you have to select all items, means suppose scheme have applied on all items, so you will select all from here. For now, in our example, we have received an offer on 2 soaps. So for now, we will select yes. As you will select yes, items window will open in front of you. From here, by pressing plus key, you will select that product on which the offer is applicable. So we will select Dove Fresh Moisture or Lux Creamy White. After that, you will press escape key. If suppose the offer is that you have purchased any brand of Dove or Lux of worth rupees 15,000, then you will get a laptop. So for that, you will select the company. Then enter on yes. Then from here, will select Dove or Lux. Next is category. If the offer is applicable, only purchase on soap, whether it is Lux, Dove or Pears. So you can directly select soap. For now, we will remain it as it is. Next option is claim. If supplier has offered according to quantity, so you will select quantity. Like suppose supplier has offered that if you have purchased 500 quantity of Dove or Lux, any of this, so for that you will get a reward. So you will select quantity and define here 500. And if the offer is on amount, so you will select amount. Like suppose offer is, if you will do the purchase of total amount of rupees 15,000 on Dove or Lux items. So in that case, you will get an reward. So for that, you will select the amount and define here 15,000. Then is quantity plus free. It means if the quantity which you are purchasing from your supplier and free quantity is also there along with it, and if free quantity is also considered in the total quantity of purchase, then you will select quantity plus free. Suppose offer is purchase on 500 quantity, and out of 500 quantities you are getting 10 items as free from your supplier, so that 10 items will also consider in purchase. So then you will select quantity plus free option. For now, we will select quantity. Next is claim on. Now the offer is on purchase of 500 quantities. So if the supplier tells you that if you have done purchase of 500 quantities, then you can claim the reward. So you will select purchase. But if supplier says that whatever you have purchased from me, out of which whatever the quantity is left after deduction, the purchase return, then you can claim the reward. So in this case, you will select purchase minus return. And similarly, if supplier says that whatever the quantity has left after deducting the breakage expiry from purchase, then on that you can claim the reward. So in order to do that, you will select the third option. Next is claim detail. In this space, you can define all the details related to this claim for your future references. So after filling all the details, you will press the page down key in order to save the purchase claim entry. So this is a claim entry which we had just created. In the same way, you can do all the claim entries and save them. You can also check here that how much percent target you have achieved, and you can also view the claim details at the side of the software. Below, you can see some shortcut keys, in which first shortcut key is F2, that is for new. You can do new claim entry by pressing F2 function key. If you want to modify any claim entry, then you will switch to that entry and press F3 function key. Now if you want to take a printout of any particular claim, so you will press F10 function key on that claim. And now suppose if you need to take a printout of claim number 003, so we will switch on it and then press F10 function key. And then we will enter on print 003. So this is a print preview. From here you can check that from which supplier how much purchase you had done till now, and how much offer is applicable, and how much has been achieved, and whatever the details you had entered, that will be also shown here. You can also refresh the list by pressing F10 function key. If you want to refresh a particular claim entry status, so you will press the F10 function key by going on that claim. Then we'll enter on refresh 001. If you want to refresh all claim entries, so for that you will enter on refresh all. The claim which is already been selected for now means claim 001, and if you want to close it, So you will enter on close, and after entering on close, this claim will get closed and will get removed from the list. Those claims which you have closed, you can view them by going on purchase claims closed option. Now we will see the process of sales claim. You will enter the sales claim pending for entering the sales claim entry. Firstly, you will specify whatever the offer you are giving is valid from which date to which date. Then is select. Here you will select whether you are creating the offer for customer or salesman, or for the team of the salesman of the particular, or for the team of the salesman of the particular route. So firstly, you will select customer and see. Then we will enter on yes. Now from plus key, you will select that for which customer you are creating this particular offer. You can also select multi-ledgers if you want. Now suppose you are a supplier and you are one of the customer who have many retail outlets. So you have created an offer for your retail outlet customer that if we have done the purchase of rupees 30,000. So you will give him a motorcycle as a reward. So in that case, you will select all the retail outlets ledgers of that customer. Now we will select salesman and see. In this way, your salesman ledger will be shown here, and from here you will select that particular salesman you are giving the offer by pressing plus key. In the same way, by selecting area, you can set this offer for that particular area. After that, you will select that offer which you are giving is whether on a particular item or company or category. For now, we have selected an item. Then after that, you will select that the offer which you are providing is for all items or for particular item. For now, we will select all. Next, you will select whether you are giving reward on quantity wise purchase, on quantity plus free, or on amount. We will give the reward on amount purchased. So we will select amount. In this way, we will specify that if Ram Avatar salesman had done the sales of rupees 10,000 between the dates 1 to 15. So we will offer him a Shimla trip as a reward. Then we will press page down key in order to save this. In this way, all your sales claim entries will get saved. Here also, there are same shortcut keys. F2 for creating new sale claim and F3 to modify sales claim entry. Now we will press F10 function key to take a printout of the selected claim. And if you want to refresh that particular claim, you will enter on second option. And if you want to refresh all the claims, then you will enter on refresh all and enter on closed if you want to close the selected claim. The sales claim which we have closed can be viewed in sales claim closed option. So friends, in this way we have learnt about claims and statements option. Thanks for watching.